أعوذ بالله السميع العليم من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين، حمدا بجميع المحامد على جميع النعم، حمدا لا يتناهى ملء السماوات السبع وملء الأرض السبع وملء ما شاء الله من شيء بعد، كما تحب يا ربي وترضى، ولك العتبى حتى ترضى، ولا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله العلي العظيم. جزاكم الله خير for coming وبارك الله فيكم. And we ask Allah to make it in our balance in front of Allah. And we ask Allah to admit us to Jannah and save us from النار. And remember me in the best of your dua, and the angel will return the same dua to you inshallah. Going on with, I used to say before, making the house of Allah alive, which I don't think that it is a good expression. The best way is how to make yourself alive by coming to masjid. How to make yourself alive when you are connected to Allah, when you come to the jama'ah, when you stay in the house of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And this is the best way of expressing that. And we stopped the last time with hadith of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, which it is a big warning, and it is in Muslim. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, لَا يَزَالُ قَوْمٌ يَتَأَخَّرُونَ حَتَّى يُؤَخِّرَهُمُ اللَّهُ. Some people will be getting late and get used to be late until Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will delay them, will make them normally getting late and coming late always. And this hadith is يعني, a big warning to every Muslim. Never delay yourself. Otherwise, Allah, Rasulullah say, حتى يؤخرهم الله. Do not delay yourself. Otherwise, Allah will delay you. Allah will make you to come late. And we take the hadith of Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم in Bukhari, volume number 6, hadith 152. Rasulullah said, I'm going to do, but he doesn't do it, to make somebody to do the iqama and choose one of you to lead the prayer, then I will go to the people who in their home does not come to the jama'ah, and I will burn this house, their houses upon them. Why? He said, because not coming to the house of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. For that, we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make us always the foremost of the people who is foremost in performing the good deeds, foremost in coming to the Masjid of Allah, foremost in performing the prayer in its early time. Say Ameen. And we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala not to make us of the people who delay or people who come late after already the first takbir, as I told you, after the prayer. Sahaba, because of knowing the value of the prayer in jama'ah of the masjid and attending for before the prayer, if one of them delayed for or come late after takbirat al-ihram, only just the first takbir, Allahu Akbar, they used to go to do ta'ziyah to him. You to go to him and do condolence, do mourning. Because of what? Losing takbirat al-ihram, not the first rak'ah and second rak'ah and third rak'ah, and coming at the end of the prayer. And we stop also with hadith of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in Bukhari and Muslim agreed upon that seven different kind of people will be shaded by the shade from Allah when there is no any shade except from him. Number one, a just ruler. Number two, a youth brought up with the ibadah of Allah Azza wa Jal. And the third one of them will be shaded by the shade from Allah when there is no any shade and the sun will be very near and it is burning and so hot. And some people will be in their sweat till middle of them, some bee will be swimming, some bee will be till the neck of them, drowned in their sweat out of the so much heat. That one of them, a man, his heart attached to the masjid. In narration of another narration, every time he get out, he loved to come back. In the third narration from Imam Ahmad, he said, out of the love of the house of Allah, it is in the root of the heart. Number four, two people, they love each other for the sake of Allah. When they meet for the sake of Allah, like in jama'ah, like doing some good deeds. Even when they depart also for going to do good deeds. Let us do this, let us do that, to help for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Number five, a man was called by a beautiful woman and in a position. Two, attracted, and the most attracted thing in any woman. Beautiful and in a position, high position, and not him is the one who call her. She make it so easy to him. She is the one who call him to do haram. She said, "Inni akhaf Allah. I fear Allah Azza wa Jalla." This is the one who will be shaded by the shade from Allah, will be protected, will be helped, will be saved, when other people, a lot of other people will not be. Number six, a man, he mentions the name of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala secretly by himself, and the tears come out of his eye out of fear of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Number seven, a man do sadaqah so secretly, sincerely for Allah until his left hand doesn't know what his right hand did for the sake of Allah Azza wa Jalla. But the main point in this one related to the tawbah, a man his heart attached to the house of Allah, to the masajid. Some of the people, and alhamdulillah, a lot of the Muslims, when they go any place traveling, the first thing they look for in the place they are traveling to, another city, another state, another country, the masjid. Because it is in their heart, it is in their blood. And coming early, the summary of whatever we take before, when you come early before the time, and especially at the day of Jum'ah, and we'll have one point about the Jum'ah itself, then you will do, it will be a time for you to do more zikr of Allah, more asking forgiveness, more dua, more reading of Quran, more listening to the Quran, more thinking about the ayat of Allah Azza wa Jal, more time for you to be directly connected to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, also more time to be far from the dunya and from the calamities of the dunya and the business of the dunya. Maybe you'll pray two rak'ah tahiyyat al-masjid and Allah accepted. Maybe two rak'ah of sunnat al-haja, two rak'ah of sunnat al-istikhara, two rak'ah shukr for Allah Azza wa Jal, even at one sajda for the sake of Allah Azza wa Jal. For that coming early, a lot of benefit. Because my topic about coming early to the masajid of Allah and making yourself alive by coming to the house of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Also, if you know the benefit of coming early, listen to what Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم saying. In al-Bukhari and Muslim, agreed upon, قال لو يعلم الناس ما في النداء والصف الأول. حتى تأتي للصف الأول لابد أن يكون مبكرا. وكل الصف الأول ليس كمثل بعضهم. من جاء أولا فهو سيحصل على أجر أعظم. ثم لم يجدوا إلا أن يستهموا عليه لاستهموا عليه. ولو يعلمون ما في التهجير أي التبكير أحد معانيها لاستبقوا إليه. وقال صلى الله عليه وسلم خير صفوف الرجال أولها وشرها آخرها وخير صفوف النساء آخرها وشرها أولها. رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم say if the people knows what the benefit and what the reward and what will they get when they come and do the azan, النداء الأذان, and being in the first صف, if they know the benefit of these two, doing the azan and the first صف. And a lot of other ahadith about the azan also. المؤذنون أطول الناس أعناقا يوم القيامة. The people who do azan is the one who have the longest neck. Longest neck is Arabic expression. Means they will be honored and respected and in a very high position in the day of judgment. ثم لم يجدوا إلا أن يستهموا علي. Then they didn't find except to do قرعة, to do drawing lots. In order to be doing the azan, suppose 5-6 people want to do azan, and a lot of people coming and they want to be, then they didn't find any way except to do, they will do it. Because of what? If they know the benefit of it, if they know the reward of it, if they know the rahmah from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and the love of Allah to those who do that. وَلَوْ يَعْلَمُونَ مَا فِي التَّهْجِيرِ لَاسْتَبَقُوا إِلَيْهِ. And if they know what is the benefit and what the reward of coming early to the prayer, for the jama'ah in house of Allah Azza wa Jal, then they will have a competition between each other to come to it. In another hadith of Rasulullah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam says the best saf of the men is the first, and the evil one, or the, we can say the lowest in reward, will be the last one. Opposite of the woman, the best saf is the last one, she come late, and the first saf is not. Because hadith of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, her prayer in her house better than her in. But this is does not prevent, because Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam say, do not prevent the ladies of Allah from coming to the house of Allah, coming to learn the Quran, coming to learn the deen, coming to learn the ahadith of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. There is no any doubt this is the best place, because one of the rule of the masjid is the teaching. One of the rule of the house of Allah azza wa jal, teaching the people their religion and apply it in the house of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. When you are coming, Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam advised us in Bukhari and Muslim, إذا سمعتم الإقامة لم يقل الأذان حتى الإقام فامشوا وعليكم السكينة والوقار ولا تسرعوا. Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam say, if you hear even not the أذان, even the إقامة, because back home the masjid is very near and the speakers, loud speakers there, we hear it. If you hear the إقامة, don't run. Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam say, still coming, walking. and have the tranquility and have the dignity and do not rush. Even he say walk, but at the end of the hadith he say do not. This apply to us when we are driving and you know that the time is late. Do not hurry. Calm with that, because the hadith of Rasulullah. When you hear even the iqama, you know that already the time of the prayer. Calm with the tranquility and come whatever you catch, pray and whatever, but bitter there is no any doubt. Ihris ala salah. That be eager and have a strong love to come early to the prayer. And if you want the reward of doing the whole night of Qiyam al-Layl, even while you're sleeping, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam say, Man salla al-Isha fi jama'a, fakanama qama nisf al-Layl. Whoever prays Isha in jama'a, he will get the reward of doing the half of the night. Doing Qiyam al-Layl, half of it. Whoever pray, just pray in the Isha in jama'a, with the jama'a, will be calculated to you half of the night. Half of the night doing qiyam and doing prayer and doing zikr of Allah and doing istighfar. وَمَنْ صَلَّى الْفَجْرَ فِي جَمَاعَةٍ فَكَأَنَّمَا قَامَ اللَّيْلَ كُلَّهُ. And whoever prays the fajr in jama'a as if he prays a whole night. Two interpretations for al-fajr. They say means al-isha will be till the half of the night, and if you pray al-fajr will be the whole night, means the other half. But the most correct one that if you pray even al-fajr alone in jama'a will be calculated to you the whole night. Because the hadith saying, وَمَنْ صَلَّى الْفَجْرَ فِي جَمَاعَةٍ فَكَأَنَّمَا قَامَ اللَّيْلَ كُلَّهُ. If you pray الفجر in jama'a as if you pray the whole night. If it is half of the night, Rasulullah will say, as if he prayed the other half of the night. He does not say the other half of the night. He say, if you pray الفجر, as if you pray the whole night. But it could be, والله أعلم both. In another hadith of Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم, وَمَنْ صَلَّى الصُّبْحَ فِي جَمَاعَةٍ فَهُوَ فِي ذِمَّةِ اللَّهِ عَزَّ وجل. Whoever prays al-fajr with the jama'ah, he is fi zimmatillah, means under a lot of meaning under it. A lot of means under the protection of Allah, under the security of Allah, under the safety from Allah, will be protected, will be helped, will be aid. This is the word zimmatullah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Some of the meaning of it. One of the benefit also, and one of the reward you will get, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam saying, Ala tasuffuna كما تصف الملائكة عند ربها. Would you like to do your صف as the angels doing their صف with Allah سبحانه وتعالى, as the angels doing their صف their rows with Allah سبحانه وتعالى. قالوا يا رسول الله وكيف تصف الملائكة عند ربها, how the angels they do their صف with Allah سبحانه وتعالى. قال يتمون الصف الأول ويتراصون. They perform the first صف and complete it, because sometimes in Jum'ah and sometimes if there is big number in some masajid, you will find some gaps in the edge of the saf. Sometimes the first saf is not complete. For that, the imam usually should say, "Atimmu saf al-awwala, thumma al-ladhi yalihi, thumma al-ladhi yalihi." Perform and complete and fill the gaps of the first saf, then the one after, then the one after, and going on. For that, this is the way of the angels with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Yatarasuna. They come to the first saf and complete it, and they are shoulder by shoulder and heels by heels. No gaps between the heels and the shoulders also. وَكَانَ النَّبِيُّ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ يَمْشِي بَيْنَ الصُّفُوفِ يُسَوِّيهَا. And he used to go in between the saf to make it straight. Because إِنَّ اللَّهَ لَا يَنْظُرُ إِلَى الصَّفِ الْأَعْوَجِ. Allah will not give a mercy to the saf if it is crooked. If it is some in front and some in back and this. And they're straightening the saf by the heels, not by the beginning. Not by the toes. Because some of the people they do by the toes, especially in the first saf. And if the first saf is not in doing the with the heels, second will be the same, third will be the same, out of making the first saf short. The space of it, if it is very near to the wall, then they will be doing the straightening the saf by the toes, by the beginning of their feet. Then second saf will be behind little bit, and third saf will depend on the first and depend and going on. But if it is by heels and giving more space in the first saf to be enough for sujood, then secondly will be the second saf will be depending on the first and going on the place. And especially these lines, it make it easier for the people. Which some of the ulama, you know, they said that is a bid'ah, is not, it should not be there. But the people themselves, if you leave them without, you'll find the saf very crooked. And some of the people, as if subhanallah, sorry for saying that, like if they are nailed in the land. You try to fix the saf, no way. الله عز وجل سي وفي ذلك فليتنافس المتنافسون. In this, there should be people getting competition with each other. Race for, سارعوا إلى مغفرة من ربكم ورحمة. Race for the مغفرة. Hasten, I mean, hasten for the مغفرة. Hasten and try your best to get the مغفرة of Allah, to get the رحمة of Allah سبحانه وتعالى. Maybe some of the people, they come early in the salawat and in the jum'ah, but the problem is they sit in the end. In jum'ah especially, I see a lot of people. One of the conditions, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam say, especially in jum'ah, to get the مغفرة for the next jum'ah, and to have the qiyam and siyam of the whole year, that they come, وَدَنَا مِنَ الْإِمَامِ. Dana min al-imami means he come near to the first saf, near to the imam. Or that this is one of the superiority of also and getting a condition. I will come to this condition later with the details of it. To get the reward of al-jum'ah and having a lot of barakah till the next jum'ah. One of it is, yes, they come early. I see some of the people come sometime half an hour or more earlier than the time. But they sit at the end. No. The Islamic way is come to the beginning. And come to, as the hadith saying itself, Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم, hadith al-sahih, قال, ودنا, about the jum'ah, ودنا من الإمام, and he come near to the imam. For that being far at the end of the masjid, only just to relax and time your sleep, is not good. And all the salah is a kafara, is expiation and forgiveness for the sin. In Muslim, Imam Ahmad, in Nasa'i, Ibn Majah, and Ibn Majah 543, Nasa'i 118, Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم say, ما من امرئ مسلم تحضره صلاة مكتوبة. Any Muslim come to him or يعني getting in time of prescribed prayer. صلاة مكتوبة من the فرض. ظهر والعصر والمغرب والفجر والعشاء. فيحسن وضوءها. He did firstly the وضوء perfectly. This is the condition of right salah, right وضوء. Condition of the right وضوء, right استنجاء. With the water and doing the sunnah of Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم. Then after that, to the perfect wudu and complete from beginning till the end. وَخُشُوعَهَا. Then he come to the prayer with a khushu'ah. Leave the world with the shoes. When you take out the shoes, take out the worldly life with it. Because Shaitan will never leave you alone. When you come to the prayer, he will make you to remember everything. Remember the story of Shafi'i, I told you before. A man came to him, he said, I already bury some of my money somewhere and I forget where it is. He said, go and pray the whole night, tomorrow I will let you know. Just Allahu Akbar, he remember where it is, he left the prayer and he went to find it. He came to Imam Shafi, Jazakallah khair ya Shafi. You told me exactly the affair. He said, Wallah, I know that Shaitan will never leave you to pray the whole night. Because praying the whole night with Imam Shafi is more valuable than all of this money. For that he knows that the Shaitan will remind him before he doing the prayer. He left the prayer for whatever. For that, concentrate in the prayer. Leave the worldly life. Think about the hereafter. Think about when they put you alone in your grave. Imagine that if you are alone in your house and turn off the light. Some of the people will get scared. And this is still in the worldly life. All the neighbors around you and telephones everywhere and so on and so on. And many kind of way to contact others. But still, what about if you are in your grave and you have no way? Cannot get out. And only your good deeds or bad deeds will be with you. Think about that and perform the ruku' as Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم say يحسن وضوءها وخشوعها وركوعها. Did the ruku' perfectly as it should be to be done. Did the sujood also perfectly as it should be done. Some of us they do the ruku', believe me, like that. This is the body and this is the upper part of the body. It should be like this. It should be, this is straight. Except if you have a problem, back problem or a disc problem, or this will ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives him shifa. But if it is not, the back should be straight and the head should be straight to the, go back to the halaqat of the salah. Description of salah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, I explain that with all proofs. For that performing the ruku' should be until you do complete and perfect ruku' and doing the tasbih at least 3 times. Then saying, سَمِعَ اللَّهُ لِمَنْ حَمِدَ Rasulullah say, حَتَّى تَعُودَ كُلُّ عَظْمٍ إِلَى مَكَانِهَا. Until every bone goes back to its place. Because some of the people, Allahu Akbar, Sami Allahu Alhamd, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, fast, so fast. This is not a prayer. As a man who did in front of Rasulullah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, the prayer, Rasulullah called him and said, go repeat your prayer, you did not do. Then he did the second time, so fast, go repeat your prayer. Then the third time, go repeat your prayer. افطر ذاتي وانه رسول الله ست وهم صلى الله عليه وسلم سيدي يا رسول الله والله لا احسن غير هذا. I do not know better than this. This is what I know. Then رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم start teaching him and teaching the whole ummah that do the ركوع and have تمأنينة, because ركوع bending yourself like that, this is one ركن. And التمأنينة having a time, another ركن separate than the ركوع. For that, in doing the ركوع, there is two ركن. One ركن is الله أكبر like that, if this is the قبلة this way. And the second part of the ركن in it is the تمأنينة. For that, if you do الله أكبر, سمع الله لمن حمده, you lost one. You lost one of the pillar, which it is التمأنينة فيه. الركوع ركن والطمأنينة ركن فيه منفصل عنه. Doing the ركوع by your body, this is one of the pillar. And having a time, another separate pillar. In the ركوع, doing the sujood is one of the pillar. And doing, having time in sujood, this is another pillar separate than the sujood itself. For that, if you do the sajda and Allahu Akbar in 1 second, you already did the sajda as one of the pillar, but you lost another one, which it is الطمأنينة في ركن منفصل عن طمأنينة, which it is having a time in your sujood, having a time in your ركوع, having a time after you say سمع الله لمن حمده. Hadith is very clear. رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم saying that, صحابة saying that, sometimes رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم saying سمع الله لمن حمده, and stand make it so long until we think that he forget to do sujood, until he forget to do sujood. See الحرمين in مكة and المدينة, and especially in المدينة, if the leader of الشيخ الحزيفي, you ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless him, you will find him applying it very well. سمع الله لمن حمده, and he wait, and the people already get to know, because sometimes what? They get habit of their life, all of their life, to do after the سمع الله الحمد right away sujood. Some of the people, you'll find them going slowly, 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 slowly. If you continue like that, you will do sujood and he's still standing. And you spoil your prayer while you don't know. Because مخالفة الإمام في ركنين فعليين تبطل الصلاة. Going opposite of the imam, of the imam in the prayer. In a two ركني فعل. ركن, one of the pillar. فعلي means like ركوع and sujood, moving actions. In action, you will spoil your prayer right away. You have to do after him, not with him, not before him. Again, if you do before the imam, you spoil your prayer. If you do exactly with him, you lose the reward of it. And you should do after he finish. After he finished takbir, there is no any doubt. My advice to all the imams, if there is some of them watching my halaqat, then please, for the sake of Allah Azza wa Jalla, do not say Allahu Akbar until you say Allah. Everybody already did so good. Or ruku'a. Or sami Allahu liman hamida. Some of the imams, they make it so long. Should not be like that. Try to make it normal in order not to give a chance to the people behind you to go opposite of what you are doing. For that, doing the ruku'a perfect, the khutu'a perfect. Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم say if you do that, كانت كفارة لما قبلها من الذنوب ما لم يؤتي كبيرة وذلك الدهر كله. رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم say if you do it perfectly and good, will be expiation and forgiveness and deleting all of your sin with one condition, ما لم يؤتي كبيرة, as long as he does not commit any one of the major sin, as long as he does not commit, or she does not commit any one of the major sin. For that, the duty of the Muslim to know what is the major sin. Go back to the halaqat of the major sin, around 70 halaqa or more about the major sin, what it is and why it is a major. And this is if you avoid it, all the small ones will be forgiven inshallah. وَذَلِكَ الدَّهْرُ كُلَّهُ, and this is all the time. It's not only for some of the prayer and some other not. All the time. In al-Bukhari, hadith is so famous and also others and the Muslim Abu Dawood, رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم say, أرأيتم لو أن نهرا بباب أحدكم يغتسل فيه كل يوم خمسا أيبقى من درنه شيء؟ قالوا لا يا رسول الله, لا يبقى من درنه شيء. قال فذلك مثل الصلوات الخمس يمحو الله بهن الخطايا. رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم say, if there is a river in front of any one of you, taking a shower in it 5 times a day, taking a shower in it 5 times a day. رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم say, is there any dirt will remain in his body? They say, no, ya Rasulullah. He said, this is the example of the 5 daily prayer. It will wash you out from all the sin. There is hadith with the details actually about that point also. And hadith is sahih. That Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم say when you wash your hand, all the sin will get out with that. No water of that, wudu, and another narration with that last drops of the water of the wudu. Then when you wash your face, all the sins committed by your eyes or by your ears or by your face will be dropped with that water of the wudu or with that last drops of that wudu. When you wash your hand, all the sins committed and going on until you come out of the prayer of the wudu, pure, clean from all sin, clean from all the sin. Then, when you come to the prayer, more barakah, more rahmah, more maghfirah from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. In Ahmad, volume number 3, in Ibn Majah, volume number 1263, in Al-Jami' al-Saghir, 184, قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم, إذا رأيتم الرجل يعتاد المساجد فاشهدوا له بالإيمان. لنا الظاهر, وليس علينا البحث عن الخفايا. التجسس على الناس هذا يحرم. رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم say if you see anybody coming regularly, the condition regularly to the masjid, witness for him with the iman that he is a mu'min. Give a witness to him that he is a mu'min. I don't mean give a witness to go to him and say, but be in your aqidah and your heart that this is alhamdulillah rabbil alameen. For that, here, just coming to the masjid regularly, you are not required to dig behind him. Does he do that? Does he do that? To spy upon him? No. لسنا مطالبين بكشف عورات الناس أو التجسس عليهم. We are not required to dig behind the people what they are doing secretly. And also forbidden in Islam to spy upon the other people. Completely forbidden. Also one of the forbidden things to doubt. Oh, maybe this, maybe that. No. Good thinking about your Muslim brother is required in Islam. Or that here Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم said, just you see him coming to masjid regularly, witness for him that he is a mu'min. That's it. From here, we come to another part. ما هي الوظيفة الحقيقية للمسجد? What is the real rule? And what is the rule? What are the rules? The true rules of the masjid. What is the masjid for? Because nowadays you find the Islamic centers for everything. Everything. What is the real rule of the masjid? Go to al-masjid wa asharuf al-mujtama' for Ali Abdul Halim Mahmud and many others also. Then, the rule of the masjid, i'dadu al-muslimi al-mutakamil al-bina' making a Muslim perfect in everything. Perfect in the prayer, perfect in dunya, perfect for the akhirah. Perfect in tarbiyah wa ta'lim. Masjid is for training the people, bringing them up, teaching them, bringing them up with the Quran and Sunnah, teaching them to be a true Muslim. Ta'lim, it is teaching them the book of Allah, teaching them the sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Perfect their khuluq, make their khuluq, their manner to be the best, their behavior to be the good, to know what is halal, what is haram, what is right, what is wrong. This is the real rule of masjid, to do whatever please Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to do the ibadah. Allah says that in Quran al-Kareem. في بيوت the first ayah I read in the first rak'ah. في بيوت أذن الله أن ترفع ويذكر فيها اسمه يسبح له. For ذكر of Allah عز وجل. مساجد for ذكر of Allah عز وجل. مساجد is not for innovations. مساجد is not for only playing. مساجد is not for other than worshiping Allah عز وجل. Teaching the religion of Allah سبحانه وتعالى. Preparing the Muslim to be a true Muslim. Making the people near to Allah سبحانه وتعالى. Having the shura between them in the matters of the deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and the dunya also. How is another way? Masjid is preparing you for. Masjid is actual. Islamic center should be for. To prepare you and to teach you and to train you with how to have good relation with Allah by how to worship Him. Good relation with the other people around you. What is the right and what's your right? You learn it, especially in the West. Where you learn that except in masajid. But if we make the masajid for playing and for swimming pool and for many other things, everybody knows what's in masajid. And when we talk about that, a lot of people get angry. Oh, you don't want that. We want the masajid to be for Allah Azza wa Jal. And we are not preventing that, but at least do not make the main purpose of the masajid and house of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for all kind of innovations. Should not be. And that here, your relation with Allah, how you worship Him, learn it in masajid. Your relation with the people around you, what is their right and what's your right? And your relation with your own self, what is halal and what is haram? What you should eat, what you should not eat? What you should do, what you should not do? This is must be in masajid. Must be in masajid. And also masajid for to come to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and put all of the burden upon your shoulder, give it to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Say, oh Allah, يعني remove that from me. Ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Ask Allah to remove your burdens. Have the relation with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. المسجد مركز إشعاع وتوجيه لمجموع المسلمين. The masjid is the, يعني the source of the light, the source of the rahmah. When the people want that, when the people come to that, when the people know that the rule of the masjid is only for that, for direct the people to whatever right, مهبط الرحمة والبركة, the center of rahmah of Allah, the center of barakah from Allah, the center of learning Quran of Allah, the center of learning sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, being also far from being severed, because the shaitan will attack all of the one who is severed. When you two come to the house of Allah, المسجد مدرسة عملية يومية متجددة. Masjid is a madrasa, is a school, but universal school. If every community have a masjid and they learn from it daily, and it is you renew your information from the Quran of Allah and Sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, learn how to purify yourself outside and inside by doing the wudu and doing purifying your heart, and also how to do the fara'id, how to do the sunan, means learning your religion. From the masajid at the time of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam comes the old leader who leads the whole world. Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, when he moved to Medina, what's the first step he did? Masjid, build a masjid. First step, before looking for any house, for anything, build a masjid. Because this is the Islamic center for teaching the people, for making the community, for knowing your religion, for having a good relation with Allah, good relation with the people, good relation with your own self when you become a true Muslim. These masajid, at the time of the Sahaba, come out of it the righteous people, the real leader, the one who is near to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the one Allah loves him subhanahu wa ta'ala. The one Allah, وَمَنْ أَحَبَّهُ اللَّهُ تَوَلَّاهُ أَتَى بِهِ إِلَى مَسْجِدِهِ. If Allah loves you, will make you to come to his masjid. If you do not come, it is a sign that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is angry from you. If you do not come, house of Allah is open. For that here, مَنْ تَوَلَّهُ مَنْ أَحَبَّهُ اللَّهُ تَوَلَّاهُ أَتَى بِهِ. If Allah loves you, He will make it easy for you to come to the house of Allah. And He will put the love in your heart for it. And you will never find any excuse, because a lot of the Muslims now find million excuses to not to come to masjid. All of it not true. And all of it is very weak. And all of it will never ever benefit him in front of Allah Azza wa Jal or here. Al-Masjid makan litahrir al-ibad min al-jahiliya. It is the place, and the Islamic center should be a center for the people to free them from all kind of jahiliyyah, from all kind of ignorance. Because without that, you'll find the people going everywhere. And even including the Muslim countries now, we know what's going on. To make the masjid rule is very tighted and nothing. And even to the Jum'ah, in some of the countries now, they make it 15 minutes. The khutbah. Subhanallah. It should not be like that at all. Ask Allah to guide all Muslims. Say Ameen. Also, this is will teach you what is right, what's wrong in masajid of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You will get the knowledge. You will know what is justice. You will be far from doing any zulm. You will love Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You will have the wahdaniya of Allah to learn what is what the meaning of la ilaha illallah. Qala ibn Taymiyyah, كانت المساجد مواضع الأئمة ومجامع الأمة. Look to the word so beautiful. He said the masajid was the place of gathering all best leaders and also for all ummah. Gathering the all ummah in the house of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. فَإِنَّ النَّبِيَ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ أَسَّسَ مَسْجِدُهُ الْمُبَارَكَ عَلَى التَّقْوَى. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam start building his masjid upon taqwa. لَمَسْجِدٌ أُسِّسَ عَلَى التَّقْوَى مِنْ أَوَّلِ يَوْمٍ أَحَقُّ أَنْ تَقُومَ فِيهِ. The best of the masajid, and we ask Allah to guide everyone who wants to do masajid. community or somebody or a group or a family to start it from the beginning with the taqwa, with the fear of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The best masajid is and will continue with the taqwa. What if it started with cheating and with lying and with politics and with fighting and with, oh, I am the one who did it, then it will continue with the same way except of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Be merciful to them and find the real tawbah from them that they want the house of Allah to be really for the sake of Allah sincerely. I'm not attacking anyone and I'm not talking against anyone, not any country, not any organization, because sometimes my word is twisted very well against everybody. But this is the Islam itself. This is what Allah wants from us. That Rasulullah built the masjid from the first day of it upon taqwa. There is salah in it, there is zikr of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, there is reading of Quran of Rasulullah in the masjid. Rasulullah used to teach the sahaba, ta'alim al-ilm, teaching the knowledge, the khutbah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and other khulafa after him. For us the durus, the halaqat, feeling so sad when you find any innovation, you find mashallah big number of the people. When you find the durus of Allah and Quran of Allah and sunnah of Rasulullah, you find less people, which it is not a good sign for the Muslim ummah. But it is our duty to invite others. Alaykum as-salam. It's not our duty to attack everything and criticize everything and go against each other and either my way or the highway. Cannot be like that at all. For that he say that it was at the time of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam for dhikr of Allah, for reading of the Quran, for ta'lim al-ilm, for teaching the knowledge, for making the khutbah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, for making the halaqat, for the durus, for also appointing even the leader of the army. It was in the masjid at the time of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. By this way will be most successful one. Inshallah, the next time we'll go on with more details about the importance of al-Jum'ah. What Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, actually Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make a surah in the Quran, chapter in the Quran, al-Jum'ah. Then, إذا نودي للصلاة من يوم الجمعة فاسعوا إلى ذكر الله وذروا البيع. When the time call for the أذان at the time of الجمعة, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, hasten to the prayer and leave any trade, leave any business, leave anything, leave the whole world and come to Allah because Allah calling you. And Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam say of the opposite of that if whoever leave three جمعة, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will close his heart. Close his heart means the right will be for him wrong. And the wrong will be for him right. The halal will be haram. And the haram will be halal. Because his heart is closed. Does not accept the right. And does not reject the wrong. We ask Allah save us. And we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to seal our heart with iman. And to fill our heart with iman. And to forgive all of our sin. And to make on our heart the love of coming to the house of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. With a good and sincere intention for the sake of Allah Azza wa Jal alone, without creating any kind of problems in the house of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, without being a reason for preventing other people from coming to the house of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and we ask Allah to accept all of our own good deeds. Allahumma ghafir lana dhunubana, wa kaffir anna sayyatina, wa tawaffana ma'al abrar. وأعنا على ذكرك وشكرك وحسن عبادتك واهدنا واهد بنا واجعلنا سببا لمن اهتدى اللهم إنا نسألك الهدى والتقى والعفاف والغنى واغننا بحلالك عن حرامك وبطاعتك عن معصيتك وبفضلك عمن سواك اللهم اجعلنا وأهالينا وبلادنا وبلاد المسلمين في ضمانك وأمانك وإحسانك وحفظك ورعايتك ونصرك وتأييدك وانصر الإسلام والمسلمين فوق كل أرض وتحت كل سماء وارحمنا برحمتك التي وسعت كل شيء ويسر لنا أمورنا واشرح لنا صدورنا واغفر لنا ذنوبنا وكفر عنا سيئاتنا اللهم إنا نسألك الهدى والتقى والعفاف والغنى اللهم من أردت هدايته فاجعلنا سببا يا ذا الجلال والإكرام لمن اهتدى يا حي يا قيوم اللهم إنا نسألك باسمك الأعظم الفردوس الأعلى في الجنة وما قرب إليها من قول أو عمل ونعوذ بك اللهم من النار وما قرب إليها من قول أو عمل وصل اللهم على محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم تسليما كثيرا وجزانا وجزاكم الله خيرا and remember us in the best of your دعاء والسلام عليكم ورحمة الله